I think that controlled the original Matrix, which would have certainly been in operation when you were here.
It would have been, yeah.
Because that was working in, until about 91 or 2.
Want to go downstairs?
Yeah, okay.
Wow. Constant pressure measuring cell.
Into a dummy load.
I'm going to show you some more original equipment from 1940, still in daily use. Not this.
No, this is quite new. This is from about 10 years ago. But you'll find references here to 250 kilowatt transmitters.
Yep, coming.
At least the platinum ducts.
Ah, yes.
Silvering air.
It's like.
We have dust filters there.
Yeah.
Okay, and then that's the water cooling there.
It's only doing a few revs.
When was the last time you saw a PC with a turbo button?
Wow.
And a
It's very modern, isn't it?
That's driving the aerial matrix switch.
Is that right?
That area up there where the top running is normally a bit hotter than RF, behind that red white tape that at the moment it's only just in a cycling standby mode. The way out here.
You want to walk out that way?
Yeah. I'll go first. This is heading out towards that area near the aerial switch.
Ah, yes.
We're probably between the aerial switch and Verney Road. And there's a trapdoor up here. You push the trapdoor up and pop up out from the aerial paddock. Yeah, we're fairly close to the aerial switch, that's what it's got a sign on it saying. To go out, this used to be a runway for water ducts for the heat exchangers when they had water cooled transmitters.
Yep.
You'd have black pipes going on. First day book commenced in June 1963, and the last entry was 1986, so it ran for 23 years. Death hole. Rose thorn. Things are very orderly and well maintained on this site. These are those shots I was telling you about.
Ah, yes.
Okay. Okay, so they're lined with an abrasive, a carborundrum held on with a tough glue. And you just wrap them around the things and use them for anchors or joints. Mm. Everything to do with the PX group antennas is made of aluminium.
Oh, hi, fuck.
That was for a four-wire feeder, low loss.
Yes, yes.
So this was a four-wire, which I think worked out at about 300 ohms. If you pick any two of those, the top two or the bottom two, and run a pair of wires through there, the spacing works out at 450 ohms, the same as that ladder line.
Yeah. Just looks like telephone insulators there.
They do use some of these still on the dissipative line. Remember when it was covered in cobwebs? I'm just going to walk through your field of view. They used to get, you've probably seen those the medium wave sites.
That's right, yeah.
They had two sorts. They had ones like these, the white ones, and the brown ones, the chocolate brown ones were more like that.
Yeah.
They were known by the staff as Marilyn's or Ligatids. When you can make such references, Lap Insulator is a well known insulator company in America. Oh, Lap is still in existence, they've been making insulators for ages. These big something screw is very good, I suggest that. Scrap metal.
Test.
Here we go, this one's 25 puff. Well, they're probably all 25s, yeah. They're rated according to 35,000 volts. They used to plug these in when you're tuning the old transmitters, so you had to add extra. They're fairly old, though. They're sort of like 1930s design. We used stacks of them, if you had a polyphase rectifier, you'd have ventilators of some of the RCA. RCA transmitters, which is a 4CX1500A. That's a 4CX1500A. Nice little 1500 watt external anode tetrode. 20 kilowatt diode.
Really?
2CX. 10 kilowatt. 2CX10000. That's a damper diode. This is an 880, an RCA.
Don't drop it.
No, I won't drop it.
They'd be worth a bit, wouldn't they?
This is a 10 kilowatt triode. That's its anode. So it hasn't had much use. That's its anode in there, so this has to go into a jacket. It's held up at high voltage, so you need to have an isolated water column.
$21,000
worth of this. Use for a cheap one.
good TV reception.
They would, wouldn't they?
Up 2 seconds. Still bolted together.
Right.
Postmaster General's Military Department, Radio Australia, International High Frequency Transmitting Station. I still refer to it as IHFTS.
Good guy, don't see fencing done like that these days, do you?
Blackmail.
On the disc anyway.
Yeah.
And the other three are slow when you can steer them from left to right.
Compare it to the contemporary material, so it's mechanically quite different.
Is that my chance in instruction?
And I can a powered winch, and I just drive it and raise and lower the our eyes. These days, unless it's a catastrophe.
Yeah, I should have to think what stainless steel wire costs. I'm sure it's more expensive than copper.
On the, you see where the feed line comes in here onto J11?
In the copper?
Yeah.
There's little blocky things.
Okay.
Unless you want there's an outlet channel on that.
Hi. Yep.